Welcome. In this video, I'm going to be going over the initial setup of Raspbian Buster Lite on a Raspberry Pi. And this is a setup for the like console or character line interface. I'll probably do a future video on doing it with the desktop version. If you're interested in my other Raspberry Pi videos, I'll put a link below to the playlist. I'll also put a link to the hardware I'm using on Amazon. And if you use that link, it helps me out a little bit and doesn't cost you anything extra. So the first thing you want to do is go to the raspberrypi.org website and then go to downloads. And then download the Raspberry Pi imager for Windows, Mac, or Ubuntu, depending on what system you're using. So I've downloaded and installed the Raspberry Pi imager for macOS software. Then if we scroll down, we can click on Raspbian here. And if we scroll down here, we see there's three versions of Raspbian. So the Raspberry Pi imager software you downloaded can download these images and install them directly to the SD card. But I like to download the packages themselves, and I can reuse them and move them around on different machines and stuff. So this video, I'm going to be using the Raspbian Buster Lite version. It's the bottom version, and you can download a zip or the torrent. Then they have two desktop versions. They have the full one and then the one with less software. So when you download this, you'll get a zip file. So it will look like this. So you don't have to unzip this. The Raspberry Pi imager software will automatically unzip it when it writes it to the drive. So it's really nice because it stores it in a smaller file on your computer. So once you've downloaded this and then installed the imager software, I'll switch over to it. The first thing you do is choose your OS. So like I said, you can download the Raspbian image here. You can do the other, which would be the light version and the smaller version, I think, of the desktop one. And then I like to go down to the bottom and I say use custom. And then I choose the Raspbian Buster Lite image. I'll hit open. And next I'll stick my SD card in. One thing to point out is that this will overwrite the SD card using this software. So you want to make sure you don't have anything on the SD card before you do this. And I'll say choose SD card. And I'll choose my card reader and I'll hit write. It'll ask for my password. And then it will write this and then verify it. Okay, so that's finished. So we can click continue and then I'll remove the SD card. So next you want to stick the card in the Raspberry Pi while it's powered off and then turn it on if you have a switch or plug it in to give it power. Okay, so this has booted up. We're at the login interface. We see some kind of boot commands here. If you hit enter, you'll see the login prompt. We want to type Pi for the username and then Raspberry for the password. So the things I'm typing here on the terminal, I'll put a link below to my website where I'll have these commands so you can look at it on the screen instead of trying to type it from the video. And to help with that, the first thing I'm going to do here is make the font bigger. So this is optional. I tend to not make the font bigger if I'm using it for myself, but when I do a video, I like to make the font bigger so it's easier to read in the screen capture. So to do that, I'll type sudo space dpkg-reconfigure space console-setup. I'll hit enter. I'll leave the default of UTF-8, I'll hit OK. I'll keep this default of guess optimal character set, I'll hit OK. And then here I want to change the font to Terminus. Now you can mess around with this and try these other fonts. I'll hit OK. And then I'll go to the bottom one here, which is 16 by 32 frame buffer only, and I'll hit OK. And now we have a larger console font. So I'll clear my screen. To continue with the theme of optional things, I'm going to set up a proxy for the package management system, apt. And I'll probably make a future video on setting up an app proxy on a Raspberry Pi. I've made one in the past on an Ubuntu system, but I really should make a Pi-specific one. So to do that, I'll type sudo space nano space forward slash etc forward slash app.conf.d forward slash and then 00apt proxy. I'll hit enter. And then here I'll type acquire. And then I'll type :// http :// and then proxy. And I always do the capitals on here. I'm not actually sure if it's case sensitive, but this seems to work. So then I'll do a quote. Now this is where I run into a problem because I haven't set up the system yet. If I type shift quote, I get an at symbol because it's not using the US keyboard that I need. So what I want to do is do shift 2 and that'll give me a quote. And then I'll type http :// and then the IP address of my proxy server and then quote and semicolon. I'll hit enter and then I'll type :O to save, :X to exit. So now I'll type sudo space raspy-config. And if you're very new to command line, if I start typing something, I can hit tab. And I hit it twice here, and it shows me everything that starts with RA. So it will try and complete the whole line if it can. So if I type, looks like SP and hit tab again, then it puts an I in there. If I hit tab again, it's going to show me the choices here. If I hit dash, there's only one option here that has a dash in that location. So if I hit it again, it'll run the whole command. So if you see people doing command line stuff and they're typing super fast, a lot of times they're using the tab completion to make it faster. So I'll hit enter. And the first thing I want to do is change my user password. And I made a recent video on changing the password and changing the host name of a Pi on the command line. So typically you wouldn't use a tool like this on a Unix system or a Linux system. So that link is in my playlist if you want to see it. So I'll hit enter here and then I'll type in my new password. And it says the password is changed, I'll hit OK. Next I'll go to network options and you'll see the host name here and it tells us which characters we can use, so I'll hit OK. So I'll type Raspberry Pi Rick and I'll hit OK. So to move between these fields, I just want to hit tab or I can use the arrow keys. So when you see this flickering on and off, I'm pressing up and down and I'm pressing tab here. So I'll hit OK. I'll go back down to network options. I'll go to Wi-Fi and I'm hooked up to Ethernet right now, but I'll go through what you need to do with the Wi-Fi. So I'll type U and that gets me down to the U's and then I can go down here to US. I'll press the right arrow key to send me to OK. I'll hit OK. It says the Wi-Fi country is set to US. I'll say OK. Now it wants me to enter the SSID. So here you could enter the SSID of your Wi-Fi network and then it will ask for the password. But I'm not going to be using Wi-Fi on this, so I'm going to cancel out of here. So I'll go down here to boot options. This gives you the option to boot into the desktop environment or command line. And this also allows you to log in without a password. So if you don't need any security and you want this to just log in, you can change that here. So I'll go back. Next, I'll go to localization options. The first is change locale. So I'll hit enter here. And I'm in the US. So the easy way to get to US here is to hit page down until you see EN, because we're actually looking for English. So you want EN US, and I like the UTF-8. So I'll press spacebar here. I'll press tab to go to the OK. I'll hit enter. And now I'll press down to go to English, US, UTF-8, I'll hit OK. I'll go back into localization options. So I head in here quite a few times. Go to time zone, then I'll go down to US, I'll hit OK. I'll go down to central and I'll hit OK. I'll go back to localization. And next I'll go to keyboard layout. So this change Wi-Fi country, we're skipping over this because we did this in the network section. But I'll go to change keyboard layout, I'll hit enter. I'll leave this as default, I'll go to OK. I'll go down to other. And you can just hit the end button on your keyboard to go to other, then I'll say OK. Then I'll go down one space to English US and I'll hit OK. And then I'll hit home to take me to the top of this list where it says English US and I'll hit OK. And then I do the defaults for these next couple things. So I hit OK, OK, and that's done. Next we'll go to interfacing options. For my initial install, I usually will install SSH. So I'll hit enter here and then I'll say yes. And I'll say OK. If I go to advanced options, I go to overscan here. And that says, would you like to enable compensation for displays with overscan? And I say no. So right now I have a black box around my screen and this will get rid of it. I'll hit OK. And then also under here, it has expand file system. You used to have to do that manually, but now it does it automatically. You can change the memory split to allow more memory to be used for GPU. You can change the audio here to go out through HDMI or 3.5 millimeter jack. And I think it's set to auto. Let me look. Yeah. And I have an HDMI monitor plugged in with speakers. You can change the screen resolution, screen blanking, pixel doubling, GL driver, compositor, Pi video output, and overlay FS. Overlay FS is kind of cool because it allows you to have a read-only system. And I've done some other videos on that. So I'll go back. Then there's this update option here. And you could do this to update the Pi, but I like to do it on the command line. And it's good to learn how to do it on the command line so you don't have to come into this tool every time. So I'll go here to finish. It's going to ask if I want to reboot. Typically I would say yes, but I'm going to go over how you do that from the command line, so I'll say no. So I'll clear my screen here. So the modern way to reboot on these systems is to type system CTL and then reboot. The other option if you want to shut it off is system CTL and say power off. So I'm going to reboot it now, and when we get back from the reboot I'm going to go over how to update the system. Okay, the system is booted up. I'll type in my username and password. I'll clear my screen. You can see here that my host name has changed because it says Raspberry Pi Rick here. So now I want to update the system. So now the proxy I entered in first thing will come into play. So I'll type sudo space apt space update. And I'll hit enter. This will download all of the, it's like a list of software that's available, but it doesn't actually do any updating of the system. So now that that's done, I can type sudo space apt space upgrade. I'll hit enter. It's going to show us what needs upgrading. I'll hit yes. And now this will download those. And it's going to download it from the cache on the system. So you see it downloaded at 47 megabytes per second. So now that the system has finished updating, I would typically reboot this, and then the system is ready to go. So I might install their software on it, I might just use it for whatever. So that's where I'm going to conclude this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you have any suggestions on doing this, or anything you thought I missed, or you want more information on, drop a comment below on that too. If you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.